fasting method. Okay, so today's lecture we are going to discuss about Karl Pearson coefficient. Okay, coefficient of a correction. What is meant by coefficient of a correction? So initially, or coefficient of correlation. So we know that what is meant by correlation. Correlation means what? How they how the two variables are correlate to each other, whether they are directly proportional. That is meant by one variable is increasing at that time, another variable is also increasing. Okay, that is nothing but directly proportional, or they are having the positive correlation. Okay, whereas the negative correlation one be considered as a inversely proportional. That is nothing but if one variable in okay, so when the one variable value increases, then another value goes on decreasing. So that is nothing but negative correlation. Okay, and we have discussed various types of correlations. Okay, and in that also we have discussed the regression correlation. So various types of regression correlations. So in that various types of regression correlations, how to consider that two variables are how much correlated to each other. Okay, how to judge that two variables are related, or how much degree of relations is there in between two variables. Okay, in between two variables. So that will be indicated by the coefficient of a correlation. That will be indicated by coefficient of a correlation. So coefficient of a correlation is a single value. Okay, single value which may be positive one or which may be negative one. Okay, which may be positive one or which may be negative one, and that indicate, that particular value indicate what is the exact correlation between the two variables. Okay, that value indicate, okay, that single value, okay, it will indicate what exactly one variable is related to the another variable, or one factor is related to another factor. Okay, so that is nothing but a coefficient of a correlation. Okay, that particular value is called as a coefficient of a correlation. Okay, now we want to evaluate, okay, to determine the correlation type, or to determine the exact relationship between the two variable, we need to determine that particular coefficient of a correlation. Okay, we need to determine the coefficient of a correlation. So one of the person, okay, Karl Pearson's has given one coefficient of a correlations, and mostly that coefficient of a correlations are used to establish the relationship between the two variables. Okay, the relationship between the two variables. So what coefficient of a correlations has been given by the Karl? So it is represented as gamma is equal to summation of dx multiplied by dy, okay, whole divided by under root summation of dx square multiplied by summation of dy square. Okay, summation of a dx square multiplied by summation of a dy square. Okay, so this relationship, okay, or this gamma is called as a coefficient of a correlation. Okay, coefficient of a correlation, and it will, its value, maybe it will be positive value or it may be negative value. Okay, so on that value basis we can judge that what is the correlation between that two variables. Okay, that two variables. Now here we require to understand the nomenclature for this dx, dy, dx square and dy square. Okay, and then only you can easily formulate this coefficient of a correlation. So what is meant by dx? Dx is the deviation of item of a variable x from its arithmetic mean. Okay, one of the variable, if you consider that x, and another variable is y. Okay, so then dx is the deviation from arithmetical mean. Okay, so arithmetical mean is nothing but here arithmetic mean is the notification is given for the X bar. Okay, so this X bar here, you can see that. So this X bar can be represented as, okay, can be represented as arithmetic mean. Okay, can be represented as arithmetic mean. What is mean by arithmetic mean? So arithmetic mean, the another wording for arithmetic mean is nothing but average value. Okay, average value. Arithmetic mean is also called as a average value. So X bar will be considered as a average value. Okay, X bar will be considered as a average value, and X will be the given value for the given period. Okay, X is the given value for the given period. So then dx, okay, dx will be the deviation from the arithmetic mean value or the average value. Okay, similarly dy will be considered as a deviation of y. We are going to consider the another one variable. Okay, and dy will be considered as a deviation of item or variable from arithmetic mean. Okay, so once again, y bar will be considered as a arithmetic mean. Okay, y bar will be considered as a arithmetic mean. So arithmetic mean means average of all the y values. Okay, average of all the y values. So average hum kaise nikalte hain? So addition of all the values divided by number of values. Okay, addition of all the values divided by number of values. So that will be nothing but a average value. Okay, average value, and that will be represented as a y bar. Okay, that will be represented as a y bar. Okay, so this is the theory part behind the Carl Pearson coefficient of a correlation. Okay, so I hope you understood. Okay, if not understood, while solving the problem, you will get more idea about this Carl Pearson coefficient of a correlation. Okay, getting everyone? Is there any question, any doubt? So before that, you must write one point. So write down. What is mean by coefficient of correlation? Okay, before Carl Pearson's, you can write coefficient of a correlations. Okay, coefficient of correlation. Give heading coefficient of correlation. Okay. So write down the degree of relationship. The degree of relationship is called correlation. The degree of relationship is called correlation. Degree of relationship is called correlation. Okay. Second point, it is a single figure. It is a single figure. Or a single value, okay, single figure or a single value, which expresses the degree and a direction of a correlation. The degree and a direction of a correlation. Okay, how one can predict the direction? If negative value is there, then negative correlation is there. So one can say that if one value increase, the another value goes on decreasing. Okay, so negative, if you get the coefficient of a correlation as a negative value, then we can say that they are inversely proportional to each other. And if you get the positive value, then we can say that they are having if one factor increases, then another factor also increases. Now what is mean by degree? Okay, degree means, let us say you are getting the positive value as a 0.1. Okay, this figure, single figure, you are getting a 0.1. Means what? If one value increased by 10 times, okay, then the another value increased by one time. Okay, jab ek value aapko single figure aisi mili, 0.1 mili, ye single figure aap bol rahe hai na, coefficient of correlation, wo coefficient of a correlation aapko 0.1 mila, iska matlab kya hai? Jab ek factor, okay, aur ek variable 10 टाइम्स से इंक्रीज होगा तो दूसरा फैक्टर और दूसरा वेरिएबल 1 टाइम से इंक्रीज होगा. ओके, सो दैट इज नथिंग बट हाउ मच दे आर कोरिलेटेड टू ईच अदर. ओके, दैट इज नथिंग बट डिग्री ऑफ कोरिलेशन. इफ यू से इफ वन वैल्यू इंक्रीज्ड और इफ यू आर गेटिंग द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन एज 1, ओके, कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ अ कोरिलेशन एज 1, सो हाउ मच क्वांटिटी ऑफ वन फैक्टर गेट इंक्रीज्ड. ओके, हाउ मच quantity of one factor increase, similar number of quantities of another factor also get increased. Okay, also get increased if you are getting the coefficient of a correlation. Okay, I'm providing the both the figures. Okay, let us say you are getting 0.1 factor. Okay, this coefficient of correlation has 0.1 factor. So in that case, if you are getting 0.1, so we can say that these two values are not that much correlated to each other. Okay, okay, or we can say that what we can interpret 0.1. okay, first of all, if I say 1 or 0.99, okay, if I say 1 or 0.99, or in between 1 to 0.95, okay, you are getting the value in between 1 to 0.95. okay, so in that case, so you can say that closely correlated with each other, okay. And if I get the values, let us say minus 0.5, okay, or any value, minus value, okay, negatively correlated with each other, okay. And let us say I am getting the positive value, but which is very close to 0. okay, or which is very close to 0. Okay, so let us say 0.1 to 0.4. okay, if I am getting the value up to 0.4, so we can say that yes, positively correlated, but positively correlate, but क्या बोल सकते हैं हम, ये closely है, closely के opposite क्या बोल सकते हैं, can you give me word, closely, far, okay, not far, we cannot use, okay, loosely away, okay, close away, so not word to word, okay, awayly correlated hum nahi bol sakte na, awayly correlated, okay, we can say loosely correlated. Okay, okay, if I'm getting another word, I will write. Loosely correlated means what? जब 0.1 आपका correlation मिलेगा, तब क्या बोल सकते हैं? एक factor 10 time बढ़ गया, तो आपका दूसरा factor 1 time बढ़ेगा. Okay, so that will be the loosely correlated. One can say that loosely correlated. So that is the effect of coefficient of a correlations. So when we get these values, so then we can interpret what is the degree of a correlation. Okay, and the direction. Okay, here I am getting positive value, that is nothing but positive correlation. Okay, if one value increases or one variable increases, then another variable is also increases. Okay, positively increases. Then here negative value you are getting. Then we can say that if one value increases, another value decreases. So that is nothing but negative correlation. If we are having the values very close to 0.1, okay, then we can say that yes, there is a positive correlation, but degree of correlation is not that much effective, or they are loosely correlated with each other. Okay, they are loosely correlated with each other. Now, to determine this value 0.1 or anything, whatever the value, what is the actual value or figure, we are going to use the Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. So write down Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. And write down this formula, gamma is equal to summation of dx multiplied by dy. Summation of dx multiplied by dy. Whole divided by. So ye complete hai under root mein. Okay. So you can write it complete under root. Under root of summation of dx square. Under root of summation of dx square multiply by summation of dy square. Okay. Summation of dy square. Summation of dy square. Okay. So ye dx kya hai? Dx hai deviation. Mean value se deviation aapka kitna hai. So dx can you can write dx is equal to okay, x minus x bar. Okay, so it is one time. I'm not getting this symbol so that I have taken x double bar, but you can write in this manner dx is equal to x minus x bar. Okay, dx is equal to x minus x bar, where you can also write x bar is equal to arithmetic mean. Okay, x bar is equal to arithmetic mean. So what is mean by x bar? So x bar, you can say x bar is equal to summation of x divided by n. Okay, summation of x divided by n, that is nothing but x bar. Okay, average nikaliye, average nikalte ho hum all the values ka sum lete hain aur total number of se divide karte hain. So that is nothing but averaging the values, right? Getting my point? So x bar is equal to summation of x divided by n. Okay, and then dx is nothing but deviation of items of a variable x from its arithmetic mean, and then dy you can write dy is equal to y minus y bar. Okay, y bar. Okay, and what is mean by y bar kya hai? Y bar is equal to summation of y divided by n. Okay, summation of y divided by n. Y bar kya hai? Summation of y divided by n. That is nothing but averaging. We are taking the averaging of that particular variable. That is nothing but y bar. Getting everyone? Okay, and dy ka meaning kya lenge aap? Deviation of items of variable y from its arithmetic mean. Okay, from its arithmetic mean. Okay, is there any doubt, any question in this theory part? Shall I write this? Okay, so you can write the problem. Problem on this particular point. problem. The following data related the cost relates the cost. The following data relates the cost of production and sales price. Cost of a production and sales price. Following data relates the cost of a production and sales price. Sales price. Full stop. Establish the coefficient of correlation. Establish the coefficient of correlation between costs and prices. Okay. Establish the coefficient of correlation between costs and prices. Okay. Now you have the data, the given data as the in the format of years, and for the particular year cost of a production, and for the particular year price of that particular produced good. Okay. Cost means how much money is required to produce a single good, okay, or a single product. And price is nothing but when you produce that, for how much price you are selling that good or a product in the market. Okay, that is nothing but price. Okay, cost is production, amount of money required to produce the good, and price is nothing but after selling that good, how much money raised or received. That is nothing but price. Okay, so you have three rows consist of a year, cost and prices. Okay, for particular year 1986, the cost of a single product is 203, and price correlated or price related to that particular product in the market is 225. So for the year 1987, cost was 216 and price for the product was 242. Okay, for 1988, the cost was 223 and price was 250. Then for 1989, 239 and 271. Okay, then in 1990, it was 248, cost was 248 and price was 275. Then for 1991, 253 cost and price 277. Then in 1992, cost of a product was 279 and price 295. Then in 1993, cost was 301 and price was 318. And 1994, cost was 311 and price was 329. Okay, what we have to do, our one minute. Okay, so our aim is to establish the relationship between cost and price. Okay, what is the relationship or what is the correlation between the cost and price that we have to formulate? Okay, that we have to formulate. So for that purpose, you need to use Carl Pearson correlationship formula that we have noted down, and that formula we require. Okay, so to formulate that thing, we required one table. Okay, I will take it on another page. Okay, so table consists of your given data, that is nothing but cost. One of the variables should be represented as a X and another one variable should be represented as a price. Okay, so here the cost is the independent variable for the prices. Okay, price of the product is depend upon the cost. So cost will be considered as X variable, which will be considered as an independent variable. And price of a product is depends upon the cost of a production. So price will be considered as a dependable variable. So cost, we have to provide the nomenclature as a X, and price, for the price, we have to provide the nomenclature as a Y. Okay. And whatever the given data you are having, that you have to put up over here. Okay, that you have to put up over here. So 203, 225, 216, 242, 223, 250, 239, 271, 248, 275, 253, 277, 279, 295, then 301, 318, 311, 329. Okay, and at the bottom you have to write the summation of x. Okay, addition of all the x variable, addition of all the x variable, that will be considered as a summation of x. And similarly, at the bottom of prices, you have to write all the summation of y variable, because the prices we have provided the y nomenclature. So summation of y will be equal to 2482. So this is my value. Please do check for these two values, summation of x and summation of y. Okay, summation of x and summation of y. Okay, then further, we need to determine the dx and dy. Okay, for that purpose, you required x bar and y bar. So x bar, how to calculate x bar? X bar is nothing but arithmetic mean of a variable x. Okay, or we can say that the average value of x. Okay, average value of x variable. So average value, how to determine? To addition of all the values divided by total number of values. Okay, divided by total number of values. So addition we have already determined. Okay, that is nothing but summation of x. And how many number of values are there? So here you can check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Total 9 values are there. So summation of x divided by n, that will be equal to summation of x we have determined as 2273, and n is 9. So x bar, okay, you can take it as x bar. Okay, so here x bar. This is x bar. Okay, x bar equal to 2273 divided by 9. Okay, and kindly check this value whether you are getting 252.6 or not. Okay, I'm getting this value, so kindly check it. Okay, similarly, you also required the y bar. Okay, you also required the y bar. So y bar is nothing but arithmetic mean of variable y, or we can say that the average value of y. Okay, average value of y. Average out kaise nikalte hain? Sabhi values ka hum addition karte hain aur usko divide karte hain. Total number of values kitni hai, usse hum divide karte hain. So total number of values 9 hai aur summation of y hamara 2482 milta hai. Check kijiyega, वही मिलता है क्या? और यस, इफ इट इज कंफर्म, देन यू कैन डू दिस ऑपरेशन, दैट इज समेशन ऑफ y डिवाइडेड बाय n, सो दैट यू विल गेट y बार एज 2482 डिवाइडेड बाय 9, एंड इट विल बी इक्वल टू 275.8. ओके, 275.8. नाउ वंस यू गेट x बार एंड y बार, देन यू हैव टू परफॉर्म दिस dx एंड dy. ओके, where dx is nothing but x minus x bar. Okay, so here I will say x minus x bar for the calculation purpose. 203 minus, okay, how much value are here? 252.6. Okay, 252, and then you have to write this value over here. Okay, so in this fashion, then 216 minus 252.6. Okay, so at the end I will write all the values after provided by you. Okay, so you can put up mention 1, 2 x bar value, dx values in the chat box. Okay, I will, for the understanding purpose, I am doing this. 223 minus 252.6. okay, then 239 minus 252.6. Okay, then 248 minus 252.6. Okay, 253 minus 252.6. Okay. Then here 279 minus 252.6 and 301 minus 252.6. Okay. Then 311 minus 252.6. Okay. So do calculation, everyone, for this, and let me know your values. First value for dx, let me know. Tell me the values for dx, everyone. Okay, minus 49.6. Okay, right. 49. Minus 49.6. So I will remove this minus 49.6. Minus 49.6. Okay. Second, tell me the second value. 36.6. Okay. Minus 36.6. Okay. Okay. Minus 36.6. 36.6. Okay. Third value. Okay, minus 29.6. Okay, minus 29.6. Fourth value. Okay, minus 13.6. Minus 13.6. Okay, do everyone do the calculation. Fourth value, fifth value, minus 4.6. Okay, right, minus 4.6. Check all, everyone, you are getting the same values. Fifth value, sixth value, 253 minus, how much you are getting? 0.4, right? Plus or minus? Plus, 0.4. Okay. Then 26.4. So here I will write 26.4. Then next. Okay, 48.4. Then next, 58.4. Okay, right, 58.4. Okay, once you do the once you done the calculation for dx, similarly you have to perform the calculation for dy. Okay, similarly you have to perform the calculation for dy. So how to perform the calculation for dy? Y bar you are getting as a 275.8. So 225 minus 275.8. Okay, 275.8. Okay, similarly 242 minus 275.8. Okay, then next 250 minus 275.8. Then next 271 minus 275.8. Okay. Then next 275 minus 275.8. 277 minus 275.8. Then next 295 minus 275.8. Then next 318 minus 275.8. Next 329 minus 275.8. Okay. So let me know dy values. Dy values. First one, 225 minus 275.8. Okay. Let me know all the values for dy with the serial number 1, 2, 3, 4. Some problem. Do calculation, everyone. Okay, let me know your values. -50.8, -33.8. I will copy this. I will delete now this. Okay, -50.8 first value, second -33.8. Okay, third -28.8. Right. Kindly check -4.8, and the last one is -0.8. Okay. Right. Next. 1.2. Okay. 1.2. Next. 19.2. 19.2. Next. 42.2. 42.2. Next. 53.2. Okay. 53.2. Okay, so now these columns, two columns are ready. That is nothing but we have now dx and dy. Next column is we have to multiply dx and dy. Okay, we have to multiply dx and dy. So that is nothing but -49.6 multiply by -50.8. Okay, and you have to write that multiplication over here. Then -36.6 and -33.8, and you have to write this multiplication here. Okay, then -29.6 and -25.8. You can write this multiplication over here. Okay, then further -13.6, -4.8. You can write this multiplication over here. Okay, so do calculation, everyone, and let me know the value. Let me know the values. Okay, for the multiplication of dx and dy. And at the bottom, you have to make the summation of all the values. Okay, whatever the values you are getting over here. So you have to add up all that values. That is nothing but summation of dx multiplied by dy. Okay, that is nothing but summation of dx multiplied by dy. Getting everyone? So do calculation, everyone, and let me know your values. I'm trying to reduce the size. But I'm not getting idea. Okay. Let's say this is 16. So this. Okay, so next is let me know your values, dx and dy values, dx multiply by dy values. Okay, I will, can I write my values? You check your values. Okay. Whether you are getting the same values or not. Check whether you are getting the same values or not. Control Z. First one is 2519.68. Okay, second one. 1237.08. 1237.08, right? Third. 763.68, right? Okay, then 65.28, right? 65.28, right? Okay, then next 3.68, right? Check your values also. Okay, 3.68, right? Then next 0.48, right? 0.48, right? Okay, then next 506.88, right? Right. Next 2042.48, right? Right. Okay. Next 3106.88, right? Okay. Now at the bottom, you have to add up all the multiplications. Okay, that is nothing but summation of dx multiplied by dy. So that is nothing but 2519.68 plus 1237.08 plus 763.68 plus 65.28 plus 3.68 plus 0.48 plus 506.88 plus 2042.48 plus 3106.88. What is the value? 10,246.12, right? Right. Okay, dx multiplied by dy. Okay, dx multiplied. What we are finding? We are finding the data required for the formula. Okay, for the formula of Karlsson-Pearson. Okay, then next you have to do the multiplication. You have to do the square of a dx, okay, and square of a dy. Okay, square of a dx means 49.6 multiplied by 49.6. Okay, that will be the square. Okay, let me know the values of squares. Okay, dx square. Okay, 49.6 square. You can write that here. And minus 36.6. You can write here. Minus 29.6. You can write here. Minus 13.6 square. You can write here. 4.6 square, you can write here. 0.4 square, you can write here. And at the bottom, you have to do the addition of all the square, and that will be considered as summation of dx square. That will be considered as summation of dx square. And similarly, you have to make the square of a dy. That is nothing but dy square. So 50.8 square, you can write over here. 33.8 square, you can write over here. Minus 25.8 square, you can write here. Minus 4.8 square, you can write here. Minus 0.8 square, you can write here. 1.2 square, you can write here. So all the dy squares you can write over here, okay? And at the bottom, you have to make summation of dy square. That is nothing but some addition of all the dy squares that we have calculated in this column, okay? In this column. So do and let me know your values for dx squares, all the dx squares values, okay? So first value is, kindly check 2460.16. Second value, 1339.56. Kindly check your values, okay, which are aligned with this or not. If any variation is there, kindly notice that variation. Do calculation, everyone. I'm writing my values. There might be variation in this values, okay? If there is, kindly notice that values. Okay, side by side, put up your roll numbers in the chat box. Okay, so that it will not consume more time at the end. Okay, because only 1 minute is remained to end up the lecture. So you can put up your roll numbers, no issue. But do the calculation for this. Okay, so dx square, how much summation of dx square, how much you are getting? So my value is 11,332.24. Okay. Similarly, calculate the dy's values. Okay. Dy square value. Okay. 0.64. Okay. Then second value for dy. Who is there? Pranav. Okay. Do calculations also, okay, after putting the roll numbers in the chat box. Third value. Kindly check the values, whether you are getting the same values or not. Okay, and dy square value, what you are getting dy square value? So I think this is your dy square value. Okay. So once you have got this dx, dy, summation of dx square, summation of dy square, and we know the Carl's Pearson correlation, that is nothing but gamma is equal to summation of dx multiplied by dy, whole divided by under root of summation of dx square multiplied by dy square. Now summation of dx square with you, summation of dy square with you, and summation of dx multiplied by dy with you. So do calculation for the gamma and let me know your gamma value. Okay, how much you are getting gamma value? Okay, let me know your gamma value. Dx, dy, d, and all these values you have calculated. Okay, we will see gamma value in the next lecture. Okay, today we are having another lecture, so we will discuss the gamma value in that lecture. So now we will stop over here and we'll continue the same things in the next lecture, and we'll try to finish this chapter within two lectures. So I want to stop the meeting here only, and you can join the another lecture. Okay, so those who have not put up their roll numbers in the chat box, do it, because I'm going to end up this meeting and it will not be recorded afterward. Join another meeting, everyone.
Hello sir.
Sir,
who is there?
Yes, sir. Khatik, sir.
Hi, yes, sir.
Gamma value is 0.993.
Okay, so what is your intuition from that particular value? You are correct. What is your interpretation? What we have discussed initially, here we have discussed one thing, that in between 1 to 0.95, then
closely correlated with each other.
Right. That will be your final interpretation in this particular problem. Okay, great. Okay, I'm going to end up this meeting. Join another lecture.